Hey guys, what's up? I'm Romina. Welcome back to my channel. Today I wanted to talk to you about 7 ways you can save money as a teenager. I know as teenagers, there's so many things you can spend your money on. You might even have a job and already make money, but there are also so many things that you want to spend your money on. And at the end of the day, it's really hard to save your money. And this video is going to be all about specific steps that you can take to save your money. And if you're new to my channel, my name is Romina Gafur, and I post videos on personal finance and other business related videos. Make sure you subscribe, like this video, and let's get into the first way to save your money. Number one on my list is keep track of your expenses. One of the biggest problems is that we all use debit or credit cards to make purchases. We may go to coffee shops, restaurants, other stores, and just swipe our card and forget about it. By doing that, you might be overspending and not even realizing that you're overspending your money. It's important to look at your bank statements consistently to be mindful of your spending habits. Using bank statements could be helpful to compare month to month on what you're spending and how much you're spending. Another useful way to track your expenses could be making a list of how much you make and how much you spend. There's so many apps that can actually help you create those lists, unless you can do it in Excel. So keeping track of your expenses is really important, so make sure you implement it in your savings approach. Saving tip number 2 is open a savings account. When we have all of our money that we earned in one checking account or all in cash, it might be easier for us to spend it all. The money is just sitting there and you might be tempted to spend all of that money because you don't have any other responsibilities as a teenager. And this is where the savings account comes in handy. Start making a habit of putting a certain amount of money that you earn into your savings account. Make sure to only spend money from your checking account and never, I mean never, touch your savings account. This will mentally help you create a habit of only spending money that you're allowed yourself to spend. This doesn't mean that you don't touch the savings account forever. When you have enough saved, you can always invest that money into stock market, crypto market, or real estate. So basically, your savings account can be used on things that can make you more money. Saving tip number 3 is learn about personal finance. Personal finance is something that is rarely taught in high school or even college. If you want to be successful at saving money and investing your money, you have to take it upon yourself to learn about that. You can actually watch YouTube videos such as my videos or read books about personal finance. That way, you can learn about investment options that are available for you, such as stocks, real estate, and the risks that are associated with them. One of the most important lessons in personal finance is understanding how the tax system works. There are a lot of ways people use to legally minimize their taxes. So being educated about the tax system can actually save you a lot of money. Saving tip number 4 is create saving goals for yourself. It's so hard to save your money if you don't know why you're saving it. So make sure you set yourself a goal such as saving for education, for rent, or purchasing a house in the next 5 years. So if you want to have a certain amount of money in 5 years, make sure to create a goal and slowly follow it. You won't be able to save your money overnight, but consistently putting in small amounts of money can add up eventually. Saving tip number 5 is create an additional income stream. You might be really good at not overspending your money and still struggle to save it. So this can mean that you may not have enough income, and that's why you can build another stream of income. There are actually so many options for you to make money actively and passively online and in real life. I actually just recently made a video on my 7 passive income streams, so make sure you check it out, as I'm sure it's gonna help you with some ideas. Also, I'm planning to make a lot more videos on income streams for teenagers, so make sure you subscribe and don't miss out any videos. Saving tip number 6 is use discounts where you can. As teenagers, you may be tempted to spend your money on new clothes that just arrived in the store, but those clothes may not be worth the money that you're spending on them when they first come out. And you may actually see them on sale in a month or so. So why spend $70 on a pair of jeans when next month they can be $25? And it doesn't only go with clothing, but also with electronics, because electronics also go on sale. Make sure to catch the biggest discounts on days such as Black Friday, Amazon Prime, or different holidays. Gaming computers, laptops, TVs, and other electronics go on biggest discounts during these days. Another useful tip you may not know about is using your student ID in major stores. A lot of major stores have a 10 to 20% discount for all students, so when you make a purchase, make sure you show your student ID and ask if they have a program and make use of it. Buying things on discounts can add up and actually save you a lot of money. Last but not least, saving tip number 7 is create a budget and stick to it. If you don't have a budget, you may be overspending your money without even realizing it. You may be keeping track of your expenses, but without a budget, you may not know if you're overspending. Make sure to make a plan on how much you're spending on certain things each month. Making a budget is an important step, but it's not the hardest step. Sticking to the budget is where most people fail. Once you reach your budget limit, you can start second guessing it and you may be tempted into spending more of your money. So the best tip is to make a realistic budget and make sure you keep yourself accountable. So those were the 7 ways to save your money as a teenager. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you found it helpful, please make sure to subscribe, give it a like, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye. Thank you.